She is the star of the series that everyone is talking about this year because it's the scariest fucking thing on television. And here she is in The Handmaid's Tale.
Because you said we would find Hannah.
You will find her.
No. We will. That's what you said. When all of this was over, you promised. You fucking pinky swore. Or don't you remember? Do not let them grind you down. You keep your fucking shit together and you fight.
Please welcome Elisabeth. I know people must be approaching you all the time now. I mean, you've always been on popular TV shows, but obviously this is a little bit different because it's, I think it resonates for different reasons now because of, you know, what's happening in our country. So is the experience totally different for you? I mean, what are people saying? Can you go outside?
Yeah. I mean, it's been awesome, actually, and very moving because people seem to be taking it in a much more personal way than anything I've done before. And I take it in a much more personal way, so I feel very inspired by what other people are saying, and it's been actually really cool.
You were texting me when I first started this show last year, and you were telling me that you were filming something in Toronto that you thought I would really, really like.
Yeah, I was like, I think you're really gonna like this show. From what I know about you, I feel like you're really gonna like this show.
I do, and I'm obsessed with it, like many other people. Don't go anywhere, and...
I don't think he's going anywhere.
Well, first of all, it's a girl, but... she's had her rights stripped from her, too, so she can't. But tell us, it's obviously based on the book by Margaret Atwood. It's not obviously based on the book, because I actually haven't read that book. But but a lot of people have read the book, so they do know the story. But for the people who haven't, it's a society that's been broken, and women have been basically stripped of their rights. They're having trouble procreating, right?
Yes, yes.
And why is that? Why can't they have babies anymore?
There's just major fertility problems that have to do with the environment and what's going on with the planet and just sort of various things. It's not that, you know, dissimilar from what's happening actually right now.
And so you are a maid, handmaid.
Yeah. Let me help you.
I'm gonna take an ESL class after this episode, so don't worry, okay?
Let me help you out. So it's a right wing. I'm gonna start talking now. It's about a right wing sort of fundamentalist religious group that takes over the government. And it's called Gilead. I know, it's crazy, right? And all the women are rounded up that are fertile and they're given to barren couples to basically breed, to have a child for them.
And how do they find the fertile girls?
Actually, we're getting into that a little bit more, but I think there was a registry that happened at some point where you had to actually, you know, register females if you were a woman and also if you were fertile. And that way they know who's a woman, so they know whose money to take out of the bank accounts. And that's how they actually kind of first start to strip the women of their rights, is they strip them of their money so they don't have access to their bank accounts. And then they also know if they're fertile. So even if you have a child, like your child is taken away from you, like what happens to my character in the show.
Mm-hmm, yeah, your child is taken away in the first episode.
Yeah.
And that kind of sets up everything.
Yeah.
So slowly and slowly they chip away at women's rights and they create this society that's religious-based, right? I mean, that's what it is.
Yeah.
And people are in the government, so they're called the guardians, that the people that are in the streets watching over you, right?
Yeah, it's kind of like an army.
It's like a militaristic, right?
Yeah.
And so what period of time can that happen over? Just asking for a friend.
Well, it actually happens pretty quickly once everything is put into place, like any sort of coup.
Mm-hmm.
Margaret Atwood actually talks about in the book, you know, that any regime, in order to sort of take over, actually puts things in place for quite a long time. you know, which is why I think people are finding it so relevant and so frightening what's happening now, is because it feels like those things are sort of being put into place. If you were to actually sweep in and take over, you would need to have things already kind of in place in government.
Do you think that this show would have resonated as much as it has if Hillary had been elected?
I think so. I think it would have been different. Obviously, it would have been a bit more positive. But I think that that book, I mean, it was written in 1985. It's been relevant for 32 years. You know, it's, there are things that were happening with women's rights before the election, you know, that, that
right.
were in jeopardy.
Yeah.
So there are things that I think still would have been definitely resonated. I'm sure not quite as much. I
mean, it would have been more, it would have been a different feeling after you would watch it, because you would know that we had a female president and that would likely not be a possibility for our future.
We were safe for a few
years. You would have been like, oh, look at this funny show. Can you imagine? You know? Oh my God. You know, like, this is so stupid.
Crazy.
Because there are a lot of millennials on my staff that are like, that could never happen. I'm like, hey, bitch. Look alive,
yeah.
Because you have to pay attention, because things like that can happen. Of course we don't think something like that could happen.
Yes, exactly. And that's exactly what happens in the show and in the book, is everyone sort of thinks this could never happen to us until it's too late.
Do we have a still of Elisabeth up there that we can throw up? I want to show your hat that you're wearing. How, why, who designed that? And is the purpose of that so that nobody can look at you? Like,
yeah.
Sexually?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's supposed to, you know, similar to what they do in other countries, it's supposed to sort of shroud you so no, so you're not an attractive thing and so people can't look at you. And
but doesn't...
So that you also can't see out.
Right.
As well.
Right. I thought the robe does that. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, just make you less attractive.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, isn't that hard for filming, though? They can't film on the side of you. That's supposed to be like a cameraman's nightmare.
Yeah. It was a little tricky to figure out. I mean, you definitely get a lot of just, like, one eye, which we kind of embraced. It was fine. The only thing that's embarrassing is when the camera's often really, really close. So the only thing that's embarrassing is, like, when you, like, hit the camera with your bonnet. You know, you're, like, you're trying to be, like, all, like, dramatic and serious and do, like, really good acting, and then you're, like, gunk. It's not fun.
It would be hard to have sex with that thing on. It is.
It really would be.
How are you able to, like, keep your spirits up when you're shooting something like that? I mean, you can't get into care. Are you one of the, you're not one of those actors,
I'm
though,
not.
Right?
That's, I'm really
like, serious.
Not. Yeah, I'm really not. I try to, like, take, you know, my work seriously, but not myself seriously.
You do take your work seriously. I think you are one of, like, the most beautiful actresses.
Thank you.
I do.
You do
that quiet acting, you know, where you don't have to make a big thing, where you have to take away your hair, your makeup, your clothes, and you have to act without being overly dramatic. And
yeah.
I think that's really just, it's so nice to watch you, especially on your other show where you do your New Zealand accent or Australian, New Zealand. I was
Australian.
Well, yeah. It's hard to decipher the two.
I know.
I love that show too, which you're
Thank
doing
you.
Season two of, right?
Yeah,
you
yeah,
did
yeah.
that.
We did
and you
that.
Did a movie, you were in Cannes, I saw pictures of you on Instagram. Yeah.
Yeah, I did a movie called The Square, which won the Palme d'Or, which was really exciting.
Yes!
Cool.
It's a great year for you.
It's not bad. It's not bad so far.
No, it's not. And you're in the movie with a monkey.
Yes.
Is it that same monkey?
What I've always dreamed of.
Yes. There's another person. Jeffrey Rush was just here. Is it his monkey that he's in Pirates of the Caribbean with?
I don't know.
Because I think there's one monkey that goes
there's
around.
There's one really popular monkey who's also having a really good year. He's just in everything. No, we had a French monkey who had... who had a very long list of stipulations and demands. You couldn't look it in the eye.
What?
You couldn't, like, yeah. You couldn't talk to her. This was one of the ones I thought was weird. You couldn't dance or sing around her, which I was like...
Because they get aggravated or agitated?
Yeah, they might rip your face off.
Yeah, they're scary. Remember that woman who had a monkey over to her house for dinner?
That's what I'm saying.
This woman, like, years ago, had a monkey, like, she was treating them like an adult.
And
then she had dinner with him, like they were on a date, and gave him a Xanax and a Chardonnay. And then the monkey proceeded to rip the fucking shit off of, I mean, out of her, or her face.
There's a lot going on there, that's weird.
Yeah, I mean, it was like, first of all, don't give a monkey Chardonnay.
No. No, no.
I wouldn't even give Tammy Chardonnay. I mean, she doesn't need anything.
Tammy doesn't need anything
to relax, really.
Yeah, she's cool.
Well, anyway, I'm just so happy for you, and I'm so happy that you came here, and
I'm so happy to see you for your
success. And everybody, please, if you're not already watching The Handmaid's Tale, season one's out, and season two is coming back on Hulu. Yeah, on Hulu.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Since you got to the end of that video, I'm going to show you something that's going to blow your mind. I realize that I've never walked up this staircase on my set, and I don't know what's behind this door at the top, so we're just going to find out together. And...
Hey guys, hit the subscribe button right now for more videos.